this absolute gigantic piece of meat that we're gonna cook on that fire. I've got something real special in store, so make sure you stick around to the end to see how it turns out. I haven't actually bought a big slab of meat like this before, so I'm pretty excited to see how this turns out. I haven't actually done this before with, or seen it done really, so pretty keen to get this one going. So the big chunk of beef that I got here is a strip sirloin. These are all porterhouse steaks or New York strips, depending on where you're from. What I want to do is I want to render some of the beef fat out into tallow, which is just refined beef fat with all the impurities cut out of it. But you've got all this thick gristly stuff along here, which is no good to eat. And basically that's what we want to render out as well. So any of those thick rubbery bits, I want to cut off and get out of it. And we're just going to chuck it straight in the pan. I don't want to cut all the fat off, just those really rubbery bits. They're the bits that you don't want to eat. So you can chuck this away, but that's all flavor that you can, we're going to inject straight into the meat. And I haven't actually seen it done anywhere. I've done it with other meats before, so I'm pretty keen to see how it goes on some porterhouse steaks. It's just starting to rain now, so hopefully we don't get rained out before we cook this bad boy. So I'm just going to cut these steaks into about 1.5–2 inches thick. Cutting them a bit thick is going to allow us to get that nice crust on the outside without overcooking it. So that's one steak there. This is often a bit easier to cut if you partially freeze it, but I just pulled it out of the fridge not long ago, so it's still quite malleable. It's a bit harder to cut, especially with these slimy fingers. If you're enjoying this video, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel to help me reach a wider audience. The best thing about this fire grill is how adjustable it is. So for this fat, I just want to have it on a low heat for the start of it, which is just going to slowly melt that fat, which is what we want. I've just cut all that fat up into much smaller pieces just so it helps to solidify, anti-solidify. It's going to turn into liquid. So the key here is just low and slow. You don't want to cook that fat. You just want it to slowly melt out. That's why I had such slimy fingers when I was cutting it all, because the fat starts to melt in your fingers. So if you're ever doing this, memory, do it slightly frozen next time. Look at me just stirring that for you guys. This is actually coming out well now. It was slow at the start, but once it starts to go, it just starts pouring out. So that's plenty enough for what we'll need. I'm just going to pat these completely dry because it's been drizzling out here. Moisture's your enemy when you're trying to grill a steak. And I clearly don't need all these steaks for me and my mate who's kindly offered to help me film this one. So I'm just going to cryovac the rest of these, and we're going to keep the two best ones to trial this little experiment that we got going on, and straight in the freezer. So there's our rendered fat, just all that golden liquid there. I'm just going to chuck that in the fire pit because that'll light nicely later. If you've got any cheesecloth, it also helps just to run it through that. I don't. I've just got some thyme and a couple cloves of garlic just to infuse into that oil, and also to go along with it, just a little bit of salt. How can that not be good? Literally injecting fat. All the best bits on a steak are the little fatty bits you get, and you're literally injecting that into the steak. I can't see how that's not gonna be good. So we're just gonna absolutely dry every part of this steak off, because when that cooks, that's just gonna release steam, and we don't wanna steam these. Want them to grill, just a little bit of oil to help the salt stick, and be super generous on that salt. It's a thick piece of meat that we're gonna try to season now. Normally like to crush this flaky salt down with my mortar and pestle, but I don't have it on me. Starting to get some pretty good flavors coming out of this beef tallow now. We live. Oh, howdy. I've just been cooking that thyme and garlic for about the last 20 minutes, and that smell is absolutely unreal. So what I'll do, I might just get them out. So let's suck down that beefy goodness. Oh. Have a look at that awesome beefy goodness in there. So just gonna make a few incisions right into the center of the meat. Whoa, it's coming through the back. Whoa, bloody shot out at me through another hole. Oh, these steaks are gonna be so good. They're coming out all my other holes. All right, surely that's enough. We've loaded them. And I got this bad boy. I haven't actually used this in a video yet. I have used it and it's bloody awesome. It's a wireless meat thermometer and it just takes the guessing work out of cooking. So I thought, why not use it now while we're cooking these awesome steaks? So what I'm gonna do is just find the thickest part of this steak just here, right into the center of the meat. There's like a little line there. That's the internal thermometer there. And you've got an external ambient thermometer on the end. So we'll just go right into that thickest part of the meat. Bang. Now I'll show you how this works in the app. So I'm just gonna set my cook up. So we'll press set. We've got beef, we've got sirloin, and we want medium rare. So we'll just click on medium rare. And then all we do is start cook. So right now, as we're sitting, we've got an internal temp of 20 degrees Celsius. We want to hit 57 internal, and the outside temp is 27. So let's get these steaks on. Have a look at all that yellow beef fat tallow. Beef tallow is just another word for beef fat, but that's the flavored fat that we put in the meat.
Sorry, bro.
So you can see we're at 52 internal temp. We've got 5 degrees to go. Reckon's 2 minutes remaining. We've already formed that beautiful crust on our steak, so we'll just raise that a little bit higher and we're just gonna finish it off. They're looking awesome. Beautiful. We're just gonna take these bad boys off and rest them over here. Have a look at those two juicy looking steaks injected with that marinade. I'm bloody pumped to try this. Have you ever done it before? Drop a comment down below. Have you ever injected meat before? And if you have, what did you put in it? Because this is one of my go-tos and I love it. But yeah, if you got something new for me, let me know. And we're officially ready to eat our steaks. That's actually such an easy way to cook, where you just takes the guessing out of cooking a nice steak, which some people might not like. For me, it's pretty easy, and that's as easy as it is. Ho ho. You can smell all those flavors straight away. All right, let's have a shot. As you can see, that's cooked perfectly to medium rare. Those juices are just running off it. Wow, that's good. Straight away, you just get hit with that thyme and garlic flavor. Do yourself a favor and go and inject some meat with some marinade of your choosing. Cook it on the grill and let me know how it goes. I'll see you on the next one. Yoo!